News for We the People News. Now, I thought this was interesting. This is just a learning video. I'm not an attorney. Ignore anything I say about law. What I want to kind of bring up to your attention about this is I'm thinking outside the box, but I seen this right here and I thought it was interesting. Let me play this for a minute. Okay, that way that lines out of your sight. Now, I used to be all for protesting, and I'm, in all actuality, still am. Right? But the problem we have today is not what we had back in the old days. When we actually protest, we protest to get people out of office, not to change a law. All right? Because there's thousands of laws that's been developed over the years, and we just never held the government officials accountable because we gotten so used and spoiled about them having the authority over us. Now it says consent from the governed. We the people are the governed. They got to have our consent, but they flipped it. And why did they flip it? Because we didn't protest when they got out of control to kick them out of office. So they got the hell of the job. They got people got to protest. And the government people, whoever there's protesting about, sat in a nice comfy office because nobody threatened to kick them out of office. They threatened to kick the law. And we all did not stick together. Why in the world are they going to change a law when you have 10 people out there protesting instead of 1,000? Alright? So the people out there is protesting and trying to get noticed. But everybody else is just driving by. Thinking, well, it don't have to tend to me. Well, yes, it does, y'all. Everything has to tend to y'all. Every single thing attends to each and every individual. If it don't bite you in the butt today, it will bite you in the butt later. And this is one of the problems because I like the sign right here of the today's version. But back in the old days, they jerked the people out of office when they got out of control. You know, it's just kind of funny how that works out and how we mindsetted ourselves in such a different way now. And this is where we have become. And what can we do about it? Well, first we had to get enough people to stand there and protest. And we literally have to actually say, hey, you're making unlawful laws. So we're protesting to get you out of office, not to keep you in office. And read this one. Sorry. All right. Once again, y'all. We keep complying. Okay? But what was tricky about this is I would have probably stepped it a little further up, but it says, we're still complying, so we're going to be fine, right? Okay, but I would have said, we are still complying, so we're still going to be free, right? I don't know. It's up to y'all to kind of look at that way. But every single time, y'all, we comply with every law. 2 years ago, we had 800 laws come up in the state of Texas. This year, we passed 666 laws this year. Yeah, leave it up to the state of Texas, right? And, you know, and I read a couple of these things. We're getting in a real tricky situation because these laws are supposed to be one at a time anyway. They're not supposed to have three different laws. Okay? For instance, and all, I think I said it before, right? One time I read decisions of what laws to pass. Well, we had to vote on one. Let's just go with A and B, okay? A had three different laws, when B had three different laws. But I agreed on one law on A, but I also agreed on one law on B. But I can't vote for them both in. And yet, there's two laws on either side that I didn't agree with, but I still had to vote for it. Sit and think about that, y'all. That's the reason why it's supposed to be a law per time, right? So we can vote. Well, but they won't pass so many laws. Gee, you think? You know, the more laws they pass, the more freedom they take. I had a lot more freedom. Back in the 80s, I used to be able to own a machine gun. Ooh. But now I can't. Huh. Because they passed a law saying I can't. They took part of my rights from decide what gun I should be able to have. Some people out there say, well, you don't need a machine gun. I don't need a Ferrari either. However, it's a lot more funner to drive. Just the same as that machine gun is a lot more funner to play with. And yes, I've shot a machine gun and it was fun. That machine gun was a sports car. You know, you don't need certain things, but it's just nice to have sometimes, right? So, the question is, if we're going to keep complying with every single beady laws that comes out, in it complying to give up rights each and every single time, you are giving consent to give up rights by complying and by not holding a protest to fire whoever was ignorant enough to pass these laws. But that means we the people would have to stick together. And we the people can't. Because it does not affect everybody, when in all actuality, it does affect everybody. And not might not bite you in the butt today, but it just might bite you in the butt tomorrow. People are protesting public schools about kids wearing masks. Well, some people are saying they need to wear masks. Other people don't need to see their mask. Well, what do you think? The government is just sitting there laughing their butts off at y'all. Because you're fighting one another. They're tickled to death. And I said this on the last protest a long time ago when this Black Lives Matter thing going important, right? They're going to agree to certain terms just to shut you up and then turn around and not do it. And since then, they haven't done what they said they're going to be doing. And there's no more protest. The government can last a lot longer than we can, because we're not protesting the thing we need to protest for, and that is to protest to fire the judges. That is to protest to fire the governor. That is to protest to fire attorneys. That's protest to fire police officers. But 10 people can't do it. And you have to be, you know, stand fast with it, right? Every 20 years, we were supposed to, every 20 years, stand out there with pitchforks and threaten them. But that's what they're scared of, y'all, because we have the authority to change our whole infrastructure of the government. It's in the Constitution. But everybody is picking at everybody because the government set you guys up to go against brothers and sisters and against brothers and brothers. Family against family. And they advertise it, y'all. If they're not wearing a mask, your family needs to call in on your family members. Yeah. That's what they did in Russia, y'all. They're pulling the same tactics as Russia. 12-year-old boy told on his daddy for not believing in communism. And they came and got that little boy's dad and killed him. And then he became a Russian superstar, a hero for the mother Russia. This is where we're at today, huh? Because we the people cannot set aside our small differences and not understanding the true meaning of the true Constitution. And meanwhile, they're sitting in their nice, comfortable office laughing at we the people. Well, we're going to give them a taste and let them think. Let them think they're the bosses for 10 minutes. But they'll give up and they're going to run home to mommy. And then when they go home, we're going to go back to business as usual. Let a crisis never go to waste. Side note is, never let the crisis go to waste where we can take more freedom. This thing we have floating around in the air, it absolutely confiscated our freedom because it was, wink, wink, a crisis. Supreme Courts have been wrong many times in the past, and everybody wants to put their faith in the Supreme Court's 90 farts. And this is what we got today, y'all. Diesel with the People News. Bye.